What's up, Knights? Welcome to the season finale of your favorite student news broadcast. On today's show, we reflect upon our time at Higley with some of our best friends, share a few favorite senior memories, and get the latest on the new statue coming to the amphitheater. The senior episode of the studio starts right now.
Good morning, Knights. I'm Maddie Farrell. Senior year can be one of the most confusing and exciting years of high school. Drake decided to ask some of our current senior Knights if they had any advice for the class of 2022.
As the school year comes to a close, the class of 2022 is awaiting their senior year. I talked to some seniors for their advice for the next group of 12th graders.
As a senior, what advice do you have for juniors who are going to be in your place next year?
Don't be afraid to get out of your comfort zone, try new things, be yourself, and be nice to your teachers.
As a senior, what advice do you have for juniors who will be in your place next year?
Make the most of it. This is your last year. Make friends, make memories, because this is all you got.
As a senior, what advice do you have for juniors next year as they take your place?
I definitely say do all the senior stuff. Make friends. Don't be a loner. Go have fun. Your teachers might get mad, but having fun makes senior year so much better.
As a senior, what advice do you have for juniors as they become seniors themselves next year?
Just don't procrastinate, don't give up on your classes, do the work, have fun at the same time though.
Well, juniors, take this advice to heart and make the most out of your senior year. Thank you, Knights, for watching the studio all year long. For the last time, this is Drake Burnett reporting for the studio.
Hey Knights, I'm Lacey Simmons. This Wednesday, the Higley Choir Program had their annual Spring Pop Concert in the HCPA, where they performed songs from various Broadway musicals over the years. Great job, everybody.
What's up, Knights? I'm Nate Kinsey. Seniors, Grad Night will be held May 27th from 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. The location is the Fat Cats at Greenfield and Baseline. The night will include bowling, glow-in-the-dark mini-golf, arcade games, ping-pong, giveaways, and new movie releases. Tickets can be purchased at the bookstore or can be Venmo'd to at United-Kingdom. Come spend your last night together as a senior class.
Yesterday, the Kona Ice Truck visited campus to offer all seniors a free Kona Ice. It was a great way to celebrate the hard work that each of us put in this year. Great job, seniors, and we'll see you at graduation.
Hey Knights, I'm Hayden Ashton. The friendships we made over the past 4 years are a part of what makes Higley so special. Lacey and Michaela caught up with some Knights who have been best friends since freshman year and quizzed them to find out just how well they know each other.
With high school coming to a close, me and Lacey decided to get some Knights who have been friends all throughout high school in our rendition of a best friend tag. How many years have you known each other?
6 years.
Okay. About 2 weeks. Yeah.
What?
5, 6.
7? 6? 6th grade.
Who was your best friend's favorite teacher?
Miss Charnofsky.
He really loved her. Street love. Her class. She came in halfway through the semester and she
changed my life. It changed my life.
What is a favorite memory from Higley you both share?
Cody.
Here we go. Oswald.
You love Mrs. Breedlove's class.
But Oswald, though. He's our favorite person at Higley.
Messing around during basketball.
What was your best friend involved in at Higley?
Seminary!
Oh my
gosh. Yay! Just
no. Choir.
Oh, yeah.
Esports club.
Esports.
And especially chess club.
Yeah.
Where will your best friend be going next year?
That's why I'm to school. I don't know.
She knows.
BYU. Go Cougs.
Go.
Go Big Blue.
What's NAU?
The Lumberjacks.
Go Lumberjacks.
Cat.
The friendships that we made at Higley will be friendships that we'll never forget. Signing off for the last time, it's Lacey and Michaela.
What's up, Knights? I'm Ethan Nuttall. The memories that we made this year will definitely last us a lifetime. Maya and Maddie sat down with a few Knights who shared their most memorable senior experiences.
As we move forward in time, it is nice to reflect back.
Maya and I asked a few seniors what their favorite memory of this year was.
My favorite part of senior year was coming back the first day after we'd been gone for like 8 months and being online, not being able to see any of my friends and missing huge milestones. It felt nice to like restart and be able to finish the school year off.
My favorite memory of senior year was definitely prom night. I had a beautiful date and we danced the night away. It was really fun kind of getting to dance with our whole class because it was a senior only prom, so that was really nice.
My favorite memory of senior year is probably swim and dive season. It was a lot of fun competing against other schools and also going to practice.
My favorite memory of this year is probably either the football games or prom. I'm just like super glad that we've been able to like somewhat get back to normal and have those kind of events.
My favorite memory of this year was probably the senior prank. I thought it was super fun. It was a great time with everyone. We all got super soaked with the water. It's a great time.
We wish you all luck in your future plans. Signing off for the last time, this is Maya and Maddie.
Hey Knights, I'm Maya Griffin. The 2020-2021 Higley Excalibur has started to be distributed. If you have purchased a copy, please bring an ID and or proof of purchase to room 773 during your lunch period.
Hey Knights, I'm Sydney Merrill. With high school coming to an end, Ethan and Nate met up with some senior Knights to talk about their plans after Higley.
With graduation around the corner, we got with some seniors to get an inside look on their experience in high school and their future plans.
What was your favorite memory in high school?
My favorite memory was being the student section leader.
I think my favorite memory was my junior year. I had the opportunity to go to Seattle with the football team.
What was your favorite memory in high school?
My favorite memory was ditching class to go to IHOP.
My favorite memory was probably sophomore year. We went with student council to Disneyland, and that was awesome.
What is one thing you wish you could have accomplished in high school?
I wish I could have made better friends.
Probably trying like other sports.
I wish I played tennis. Honestly, I wish I played tennis.
Probably getting straight A's. I was really close, but didn't accomplish it.
One thing I wish I could have accomplished, it's probably a better ACT score. I got a 9. That's pretty hard to do, I think, but.
What advice would you give younger classmen?
Don't take all hard classes, it isn't worth it.
Go to all the events, like go to every football game, like every sports game you can. Because once it's over, you're gonna miss it.
Probably just to be a suck up to every teacher they have.
To say yes to everything.
To be as involved as you can in everything. And remember, Hot Girl Summer is year round.
What is some advice you wish you could have gave younger classmen?
Don't drink the milk. Don't drink the milk here.
Do not gas up the wrong girls. It is not, no. Listen to me. I gassed up the wrong girls back in the day, but man, it's not worth it, fam. Focus on the schools and chase that bag, baby.
What are your plans for after high school?
I'm gonna be going up to BYU Provo, and I'm gonna be on the swim team there.
I am also going up to BYU Provo, not on the swim team.
My plan after high school is to get swole body. At the moment, I'm kind of skinny body. I wanna get swole, huge.
Probably gonna repeat senior year, so.
After high school, I'm going to Wingstop right away.
I'm going to see GCC.
My plans after high school is to serve a 2-year mission, and I get my call tomorrow, so we'll see where.
We wish the graduating class the best of luck as they start this new chapter of their life. Signing off for the last time, this is Ethan and Nate reporting for the studio.
Recently, some of our senior Knights participated in Mr. Higley, a talent show competition where the guys battled it out to earn 2 free prom tickets. Congrats to Kenny Long for winning first place. Great job to all the contestants.
What's up, Knights? Graduation is coming up, which means students are going off to college. So we decided to test these students on how much they know about their school.
I'm Brooke Church, and I'm going to BYU Provo in the fall.
I'm Caroline St. Clair, and I'm going to BYU Provo in the fall as well. Go Cougs!
True or false, there is an 8-foot statue of Po from Kung Fu Panda in the Talmadge building.
Reveal?
Here we go.
Yeah, reveal.
Yes! Gotta go visit that one. Gotta go visit it.
How many bottles of milk do the student body consume in 1 year? A, 300,000, B, 250,000, C, 100,000, or D, 400,000?
That's tough.
How many national championships does BYU have? A, 4, B, 12, C, 11, or D, 7?
Oh, I was thinking just football. I'm like, 0.
True or false? You have to be Mormon to go to BYU.
That's what a lot of people think.
False.
True or false? Aaron Edward Eckhart, a very famous actor who played Harvey Dent in The Dark Knight, went to BYU.
It's too specific.
I'm gonna go.
Yes. It's way too specific to be false. Thank you. Wait.
Over.
Oh. Over and out. Back to you.
Signing off from the studio.
Back to you, Ryan.
Hey, Knights. I'm Drake Burnett. Seniors, if you are attending Chandler Gilbert Community College, please stop by the College and Career Center in the Media Center to pick up your welcome gift bag. You can pick it up anytime this week.
The new Higley Knight statue has gained some hype over the past 2 years. Cindy and Lucy met up with Alexa Fagrell and Mr. Fields to learn a little bit more about the project and the legacy it hopes to leave.
Hey Knights, this week Lucy and I sat down with Mr. Fields and Alexa Fagrell to learn more about the bronze Knight statue being installed in the courtyard.
When I got here 2 years ago, the United Kingdom met with me and said that that was their goal to start fundraising to establish a bronze knight statue on our campus.
The statue's been in planning since the class of 2020. It was originally their idea to put the statue in place. And ever since then, the United Kingdom has been raising money to make the statue.
Higley's Booster Club, the United Kingdom, priced out several sculptors, and the school administrators and booster board helped to decide on the person best to create our custom knight statue.
Commissioned by an artist named Scott Streedbeck. It's our Higley Knight, so he has a blue plume, he has a blue shield with an H on it, a blue cape, but the rest of the knight is bronze. He's got a big sword in his hand, and he's really, really big. Part of the purpose is going to be to celebrate our 20th year of Higley High School and to have something that represents how hard our students work and our school pride.
And just something to kind of give back to the students and the different sponsors that we've had to show our appreciation for them.
All the funds to pay for this statue came from private community donations. No school or district funds were used to purchase it.
The statue's already made, they're just building the base now, and then they're gonna bring the knight in and install it that weekend before we do the unveiling.
There will be an unveiling ceremony on May 24th at 6 p.m. Tyler Day, a 2012 Higley graduate, will be dedicating the statue. This has been Sydney and Lucy reporting for The Studio.
Senior shirts are currently on sale for $10 and are being distributed during all 3 lunches. Be sure to grab one before they sell out.
Before we leave you, Lacey put together a video showing some of our most memorable moments of this year, dedicated to the class of 2021.
Now when the sun come up, I'll be there to say what up in the morning. Brush my teeth, find that clip I've been looking for since last night. I feel so caught up. I float somehow in my bedroom. Turn around, see myself in the mirror. I guess I'm cool. And those happy thoughts in my head. I'm feeling like I'm Peter Pan. Minus the tights and the furries. Happy to see how far I've come to the same place. It began my dreams, imagination. Perfectly at peace. So I'm moving on a bit higher. I'll be up a bit away. Up a bit away. Cause they gon' judge me anyway. So whatever. I'll be up a bit away. Anyway, so whatever. I learn, I see what dreams I made, so I'm cool now. I can take care of my mom, I'm a lonely Suri, so sing along, little mama. You ain't gotta worry about no drama, no. I provide for friends and fam and fans, I cook a city grinding man. Stay afloat, the kids hope. I never let them break me down. Who gives you never don't like?
numbers off your NUTs. We don't care what people say. Dudes, you critique your clothes, I'm okay. I ain't gotta wait for no one. If I wanna fly, I can fly for freedom. Hey, I'll be up a little way, up a little way, 'cause they gon' judge me anyway. So whatever, I'll be up a little way, up a little way, 'cause in the end they'll judge me anyway. So whatever.
Well, Nights, that's all we have for you this year. Thanks for always tuning in, and be sure to connect with us on Twitter and Instagram at the Studio HHS. From all the seniors, have a great summer, and go Nights!
That's it, baby! That's it!
You won't regret it. Did I mess it up?
Yes.
Dang it.
Take two.
Take two. Senior advice with Ryan. My advice for all you high schoolers out there, juniors, sophomores, freshmen, is that you should go out and do stuff. Even if it doesn't sound fun or if it's super fun, just go do it. You won't regret it. Ta-da.
Okay.
Was I beautiful?